I apologize if some senators felt that I did not highlight these provisions in my discussions with the legislature, and in retrospect, we could have had a fuller discussion on these issues.
Congresswoman Madeline Bradalia wasted no time in apologizing for the lack of communication when it came to two provisions that were passed in May of last year in the fiscal year 2011 National Defense Authorization Act.
During the legislative process, two changes were made that I argued against during committee deliberations. They were not in my provision. And I want to repeat that. They were not part of my provision. I had hoped that we could make further changes during conference when the House and Senate reconciled their respective versions of the bill.
The two provisions have led to significant criticism from lawmakers, many who admitted to KUAN that they didn't read the NDAA for themselves last year and had expected Bradalia to give them specifics when it came to selling the Fenner Reservoir back to Gov Guam for $300 million and the Navy having 33% voting rights on the Consolidated Commission on Utilities.
I agree with Governor and Senator Guthridge that Guam ratepayers should not have to pay for the integration and the consolidation of the two systems. Offsetting...
Congresswoman Bradalia explained that it is highly unlikely that Guam will get the more than $400 million it's owed for compact impact reimbursements in the current economic climate and with fiscal conservatives in Congress.
Governor, you stated that to make your point, you are willing to walk with Senator Atta. Well, so am I. I will walk with you and every member of this legislature to FENA to show our unity and to help bring about the end to the final vestige of former naval governance on Guam.
And with the military buildup, the Congresswoman stressed that one of the first steps to embarking on the journey to winning the future of Guam is...
Resolving our political status and decolonizing Guam is a process that will cause us to examine our relationship with the United States and determine what is best for our island and our people.
She also said that past injustices that have marked Guam's history must be resolved as well, specifically referring to Guam War reparations that have passed the House five times but continues to be denied by the Senate.
As we begin to draft this year's defense authorization bill, I will continue to work closely with Chairman McKeon, and I believe that he will live up to his word. Resolution of this matter is critical this year as the buildup begins in earnest. We need to right this wrong, and we need to bring resolution to this matter once and for all.
The Congresswoman said that with the help of the Calvo administration and the members of the 31st Guam legislature taking a One Guam approach, the future of the island could be won. Reporting for Guam's News Network, I'm Mindy Egan.